I'm Bill Varney. Welcome to Urban Herbal. We like to touch all of your senses, sight, hearing, touch, taste, and smell. We make everything by hand from scratch, from personal care products to skin care to fragrances to vinegars, seasonings, teas, and we welcome you to First Friday Art Walk, because at First Friday Art Walk at Urban Herbal, we make the foods with fresh herbs and edible flowers. We have art that we showcase from all different artists in the local area, from San Antonio, Bernie, the Texas Hill Country, artists that have a passion for your sights and also touching all your senses. And it's a wonderful marriage from the artist to the art of gardening. We raise our things organically, and we use all the things that we raise organically to make the products and to enhance the artist's sight. And the artists love to come to our gardens and get inspired with the edible flowers and all the fresh herbs and the beautiful gardens.
Hey, I'm Nan Hinkey. I'm a local artist, and I love to paint wildflowers and herbs and things like that. So Bill gave me a bunch of help and showed me what flowers could be eaten. So I'm doing a series of paintings on those. Going to start with just laying out where the pots are, because these are supposed to be not like herbs out in nature, but herbs in Bill's greenhouse in pots. And I've got several little pots in the background, and then a big pot in the front. This one will be lavender. You can eat the flowers on a lavender. So I'm going to sketch in a little bit of area that's going to be some soft greens for those background ones. They're just vague, some kind of herbs, but the main lavender will be in the front here. And now we do my favorite thing, the magic of television cooking shows. We put this sketch into the top oven, and one that's got the background already finished on it, so that I can focus on showing you how I'm going to paint the actual lavender rather than you having to sit through pots and vague background stuff. So lavender has some long thin pieces. I'll start with those. I've been painting about 10 years watercolors. My husband and a girlfriend gave me painting classes as a gift about that long ago, and I took about 6 months worth of classes, and then realized, my girlfriend and I together realized, what we need is not classes for the rest of our lives, but we need to put miles on the brush to get really good at this. So we actually had a deal. Every Tuesday afternoon, we got together and we painted, and if one person didn't show up, the other person gets mad. That's the kind of accountability that really works and keeps you honest in continuing to work towards a goal. So I started out mostly interested in flowers, and that is what has stuck with me. I like light, bright things, and so the herb connection is a real good fit for me. Let's see. I need a little purple to establish where my lavender flowers are going to have to grab something down here. My little cheat notes. Lavender. There we go. It helps to do a little sketch ahead of time so you know where you're heading in a painting. And it helps not to get a lot of purple on your hand. Okay, so I'm going to darken up these long stems a little bit, because lavender isn't a real green stem. So I'm just adding some other colors in there, golds and browns, a little bit of red. Watercolor is nice because you can just let things flow together and happen sort of independently. Whatever it wants to do, it can do. And lavender has a little curve to it, so I'm going to add some curvier strands in here. There we go. The buds are going to sit pretty high. They're mostly purple. And they're kind of in little layers. I call them apartment building buds, because there's one, and they're sort of equally spaced I'll end up putting a little green in between them as we go. So I've been working with Bill here at Urban Herbal for a couple of years. He started out just interested in my paintings and put them in his gallery, and then he started teaching me more and more about herbs, so I started painting more and more herbs. Just kind of get interested in it. And I'm fascinated by the herbs that he cooks with and the different things he does with edible flowers. They're also very interesting. I'm not going to put too many flowers on this lavender because I don't want it to look too busy. I generally pick an odd number. For some reason, that's more attractive to the eye. And I'm going to give it a little pink to go in with the purple there, just because if the light was shining on it, that's what your eye would perceive, even though lavender is a rather purple flower. I'll just kind of go a little bit down the edge in the tops of some of these, in between each of these layers that I'm putting in right now. So I'm going to give them a little bit of that. I wasn't the kid growing up who was always interested in art and doing art in high school. I was the engineer. Became an engineer for General Electric for about 20 years. I was never as good at it as I wanted to be. I'm still not. No artist ever is. But I enjoyed it, and that's what's important.